2.0. Kind of the idea behind Quest 2.0 is just an event where people sit there and learn more about digital communication technology, what's going on out there. And what we've kind of formed here is we've got Brett Simmons on the very end. And you want to tell them a little bit about what you're doing online?
Hi, I'm Brett. I'm a professor at UNR, teach management. And, you know, my interest is in leadership and management. So I actually have a brand, personal brand, www.brettlsimmons.com. And that's where I blog about leadership and management stuff. Just recently started blogging about personal branding because I think it's something my students really need to pay attention to. I think it's a powerful platform. So I also have stuff on Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, but the blog is the major thing that I think you need to focus on.
And then, Larry?
I'm Larry DeVincenzi. I have a company called Smart Brand. We're a virtual agency. We have folks around the United States that we work with in a collaborative environment online. We come together and solve problems for clients in a variety of ways, using social media primarily, I'd say. But we also do traditional media, television, print, radio, those kinds of things. I'm always interested in how people can help collaborate with brand development and how you can sort of get out there and create partnerships with affiliates and move that into a great position for sales for them. So.
And then my name is Tommy Ingles. I work for a company called Expositioning, and we focus on implementing social campaigns across Facebook and other social platforms and combining it with traditional media to sit there and increase the overall effective exposure of a brand, a product, or whatever you're trying to do. We're going to keep this really simple. Is I took in, just did some research online and found the top 10 social media questions businesses and people have when they're starting out or what's going on. They're posted right up there. And those are kind of universal. And so we just figured that we would go through and just kind of talk about each one of these questions. And if anybody else has any questions at the end, they can direct them towards us and hopefully we'll be able to answer them. Yeah, and if you have questions, go through while we're going through, just feel free. So I guess really the first one we're going to dive into are, what are the best tactics to use when you're engaging in social media?
Brett?
Oh, I knew that. All right, so I don't think you should even get started until you have a very clear understanding of what your value platform is. What is it that you do uniquely well that you deserve exceptional compensation for? And you need to make the case for why you, why now. And unless you understand your value, you're not ready to go online and start forming a brand. So once you go online and start forming a brand, again, the best way to document what you do and how you can solve problems that matter to other people, which is what you're going to get paid for, is through the blog. The blog allows you to document your value, and the blog allows you to target your value. If you have a customer, a client, whatever, that you know is looking for a certain piece of value at a certain piece of time, you increase your blogging around that piece of the value equation that they're looking for. So, again, you just really have to understand what you do that can help someone solve a problem that matters to them, and then you go online and you're consistent everywhere you go.
Yeah, you know, 100%. I'm glad you went first. We do a session called a brand summit, or it's kind of like a DNA session. We sit down with the clients. It takes a couple of hours, and we take them through a process of really defining the brand, what the pillars are, what's some of the language that we'll use around. And we usually walk out of there with some sort of positioning statement and maybe even a tagline. And we try to get folks into that, even if they already have an existing brand, because when they start looking at it again, they find all sorts of things. Usually from the stakeholders that we bring into the meeting, it's more like a focus group that is really valuable to the perception overall. And from there, we'll create a platform for blogging, for social media outreach, for traditional media, or whatever they can afford, or whatever kind of staging they need. And I think the most important thing that blogs do, as well as a lot of the social media things, is they really provide you the ability to track some of those responses and get in there and find out, creating dialogue. you know, in the past, we used to talk about outbound marketing all the time. It was all about television, radio, and print. Really now it's about inbound marketing. It's about providing content for people that want to opt into what you're saying. And that's been a really strong, I think, new paradigm in advertising in about the past 3 years, certainly the past 2 years. And it's changed the way a lot of people think about their brands and how they need to position them and what they can do in a variety of different platforms. So, Tommy?
The only thing that I would add to about the tactics is sitting there and remembering your brand, because if you were a sports bar example, sitting there and talking about sports and sitting there and keeping your pretty much keeping your roots, people like consistency and people with consistent content that is relative to the information you're trying to provide, that's the basis. But developing that plan and understanding what that content is before you even start out is essential to a successful campaign.
Question?
We already kind of touched on the next question a little bit. Where do I start?
At the beginning.
And a blog is a really good just startable thing, because you can sit there and, like, with a blog, you can put video and audio and pictures and all this information that's searchable by Google and all the different search engines out there. But at the same time, there's this basis of any digital media. And with a blog, you can sit there and use that to kind of help post to RSS feeds, Facebook, Twitter, and it gives you a start, but also a reference point from which people can go.
We'll go the opposite direction, I guess. I don't know. We create two things. You know, social media is kind of an ongoing, real-time action sort of thing. You have to be in there and responding all the time, being part of that ongoing dialogue. But you also have to have some sort of editorial content that you're hopefully planning for, that you may have something to do with your business specials or whatever that you're trying to promote, maybe events. And we get our clients onto an actual matrix which just says, here's the channel, here's what the message is, and here are the dates that you're going to hit it. So they know that they have a basic foundation of what's going to be out there for them. And then around that, we kind of put the daily interaction stuff.
So when you start blogging, you need to come to grips with the fact that nobody is going to read your blog. In the very beginning, no one's going to read it. It doesn't matter. The most valuable thing that you get from blogging is thinking about what you think. And when you think about what you think, it brings clarity to what you think. And as you go online and document that and share that with others, you've got to make a commitment to what you think. And the more that you commit, you challenge, you clarify, you share, the better it improves your value, which is really what this is all about. So you go online, you make a commitment to it. Eventually, some people will read your blog, but that's not where it's at in the beginning. As you blog, you'll become clearer in your mind about how you can help people. And the more clear you get in your mind about how you can help people, the better it's going to be when you get the opportunity to help them. It's not just them finding you online. You got to be able to deliver when they find you and when you have to show up and perform a product or service. So very valuable activity.
And tag, tag, tag. Tag everything. As many times, as many ways as you can possibly think of it really helps.
And another kind of good starting point is see what else is out there. Find anybody else with blogs or similar interests that are doing stuff, and feel free. Like, I really encourage commenting or offering your opinion on different advice. If you've written an article that has relevance to something that somebody else put out there, leave a comment referencing your information back and forth, and hopefully they'll do the same. But seeing what else is out there and seeing if there's a niche available or there's other people you can work with is also a very good starting point. The next one is, how do you manage the social balance?
What do you mean by social balance?
I guess personal versus business.
I think it depends on what brand you are. Whether the brand is part of you personally or not.
And actually, all three of us
they
have
all
three different.
Yeah.
We all manage ours differently. Mine's very, I don't know if it's entertainment-based, but at the same time, I use a wide network to promote other businesses. And I really don't have any separation between my personal and business associates. Whereas Larry, you have complete separation between brand and Larry.
Well, sort of. You know, I don't know if there is such a thing as a complete separation. I think if you said